Philippine election watchdogs express concerns over the plans of the country's election commission for the 2022 polls. AES Watch says election results should be directly transmitted to the Comelec central server instead of the poll body's plan to send this through a so-called transparency server and other data centers. The poll body says the procedure was recommended by its advisory council.
May malaking risk doon. We strongly recommend na kailangan yung meet me room nandun sa, or yung mga racks na sinasabi ni Commissioner Casqueo nandun sa Palacio del Gobernador.
Meanwhile, the group Tagapagtanggol ng Watawat opposes the plan to bring to Metro Manila certain ballots and vote counting machines, which will be part of a random manual audit.
Could it be done just at the precincts itself and just have the random manual audits transmitted instead of bringing the entire machine to Metro Manila? Because that would take 2 days. And our concern is that a lot of things can happen in 2 days.
Presidential bets having common senatorial candidates, a cause for concern, according to law experts. Sherry Ann Torres tells us why.
A week after the filing of certificates of candidacy for the 2022 elections, political groups are now scrambling to scout for senatorial candidates who they can endorse and be considered as part of their team. A close look at the respective lists, however, underlines similar names in their stable. The common bets of the team Lenny Kiko, Lacson Soto Tandem, and Pacquiao Atienza ticket are re-electionist Senators Juan Miguel Zubiri, Joel Villanueva, and Richard Gordon, as well as returning Senator Francis Cheese Escudero, Loren Legarda, and former Vice President Jejomar Binay. Former DICT Secretary Gregorio Gringo Hunasan is being endorsed by the PDP Laban Cusi Wing and the Lacson Soto Tandem. Onasan explains, parties are actually looking at the candidates' credentials and platforms. Senator Villanueva, for his part, said there is an urgency to unite against the pandemic these days, thus the need to work together regardless of one's political spectrum. Senate Majority Leader Zubiri assured everyone, even if he has the backing of various political groups, his loyalty remains with the Filipino people. Former Vice President Binay also stressed the need for the broadest unity possible to help the country survive the pandemic. Political neophyte broadcaster Rafi Tulfo is in Pacquiao and Lacson's list. The tandem of Manila Mayor Francisco Isko Moreno Dumagoso, Doc Willie Ong, on the other hand, is also scouting who to endorse in the Senate race.
Immaterial whether they are liberal, lakas, PRP, PDP, ano yung mga partido man na yun, no? Willing kaming makatrabaho kahit sino. Akbayan Group, Makabayan Group. Ayoko namang i-announce. Adapt dito, adapt doon para mapunan lang yung Senate slate.
Despite all these statements, two law experts still see the negative effects of having common senatorial candidates in next year's elections.
Sana po yung common candidates, I think, should also be addressed by the COMELEC and Congress.
I consider this phenomenon really as the ugliness of patronage politics and the rottenness of our political party culture front and center, being put front and center. And it's sad. And I'm embarrassed for our young voters to be burdened by this.
With limited options to choose from, Sarmiento urges the civil society groups to intensify their voters' education campaign, while Yusinko says voters should scrutinize candidates more. Sarmiento and Yusinko also criticized some political groups for using the November 15 period of substitution deadline to their advantage. Sarmiento believes the COMELEC can actually disqualify those groups.
The COMELEC under the Constitution has the power to register and accredit political parties that only partyist organizations. It can also discredit or unregister or cancel a political party.
Yusinko has this advice for the electorate.
If we point it out to our voters that the act of placing mere placeholders is a mockery of our democracy, then we should encourage them to punish those who practice this placing of fielding of placeholders by not voting for them, for the substitute or for the entire lineup of that political party.
Sarmiento and Yusinko both asked the next set of lawmakers to remove the candidate's option to withdraw and be substituted in Section 77 of the Omnibus Election Code. Sharian Torres, ABS-CBN News.